Hi, in this tutorial, we'll go over how to add interactive checkboxes in Excel. This is something that you can use when making to-do lists, task lists, chore lists, or when you want to create forms where someone has to check off options. In this example, we're going to create a task list. We'll look at a couple of options to do this. We'll first create checkboxes that include the to-do item as the checkbox title, and then we'll create a list with the tasks in one column and the interactive checkboxes in the column adjacent to it. The process for both is pretty similar, and there's pros and cons to each option. So let's get started so you can see what I mean. The first thing you'll want to make sure of is that your developer tab is visible. If you don't see it, take a moment and go here to your file menu, options, customize ribbon, and here to the right, make sure that developer is checked off. The developer tab contains tools that you can use to create interactive forms in Excel, like checkboxes. On the screen, you see that we have a short task list with three items listed in column B. We're going to create checkboxes labeled with these task items. So in the Developer tab, you'll choose Insert, and under Form Controls, choose the button with the checked box and click on that. And once you do that, you'll notice that your cursor now turns into a small plus sign. So holding down your left mouse button, just drag your cursor to create a small rectangle. And this will be your first checkbox. So now that we've created our first checkbox, we need to rename it so that it reflects the name of our first task. So to do that, right-click on the checkbox and choose Edit Text. And then you'll simply type over checkbox one with your new task. We create new template. And move your cursor outside of the box. So the next thing we need to do is position our checkbox. So to do that, I'm going to right click on the checkbox and I'm going to click Escape so we get rid of the dialog box. And now I can drag this to wherever I want. So I'm going to place it over cell D4. And notice that I'm saying over the cell because it's not actually an item inside the cell, it's just sort of hovering there. But nonetheless, I want it to fit within the parameters of that cell. So to do that, I'm going to expand column D so that now the checkbox is within what would be the parameters of cell D4. So once you do that, click Escape to unselect the checkbox, and then you want to place your cursor in the cell. And on the bottom right corner of the cell where you see this little square, we're just going to drag this down and this will copy our checkbox for however many cells we drag down to. So then just rename each checkbox. So to do that, just right click, edit text, and change the name just like you did for that first box. The other option we'll go over is to just type your list of items, as I did here on column B, and then insert only the checkboxes. So to do that, we'll go back into the Developer tab, Insert, we'll click on Checkboxes again, and we'll insert our checkbox. Now this time, we'll right-click and edit text, and instead of renaming checkbox one, we're going to delete that. So then now we just have a checkbox. And we're going to right click again to select it, escape to get rid of the box, and we're going to position this like we did the other ones. And then we're going to come here again to the bottom right of the cell and just drag this down to create checkboxes for the other ones. And this created an extra one, so we'll just right click select and delete that. And this creates only checkboxes next to the item. So doing it this way, it's faster to create the boxes, and you also have the flexibility to format your task list as you normally would in Excel. So if you want to bold it, highlight it, any of those things, you can do that. Now you can't really do this with our first option, but by using the first option, you're able to hide any items you don't want to see. And you would do this by going back to your Home tab, and in the Editing section, choose Find and Select, and from here, Selection Pane. And this brings up this box that you see here to the right of my screen. And you're gonna notice one thing is that each checkbox is listed by number, not by the task name that we created. So you kind of have to remember the number of each one of the checkboxes. Another thing you'll see here is something that looks like eyes. Well, when you click on these let you hide individual checkboxes. So for example, if we want to hide create new template, that was our checkbox one, we can click this eye and now we no longer see the checkbox. Where if we want to hide this box, which was box four, it only hides the box, but you can still read the text. So depending on what it is that you're working on, you would just choose the option that works best for you for how to create your interactive checkboxes in Excel. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to make a list with interactive checkboxes in Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.